What's that?
I believe in the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Morning, everyone. Welcome to Flowery Meadows. It's a beautiful summer day. Start with call the roll. Mr. Long.
Here.
Mrs. Vettori.
Here.
And Mr. Bates.
Here.
First item on the agenda is approval of the agenda and addendum items.
So moved.
Thank you. Mr. Long.
Yes.
Mrs. Vettori.
Yes.
And Mr. Bates.
Yes.
Next item on the agenda is executive session. I have no proposed items for executive session. Okay, we'll skip over executive session. Next item on the agenda is to approve or amend the meeting minutes from the regular board meeting.
So moved.
Any questions on the board meeting minutes from the August 13, 2019 meeting? Not. Take a vote to approve the meeting minutes. Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Mr. Long?
Yes.
And Mrs. Vettori?
Yes.
Next up is a presentation of the financial statement for the month ending August 31st, 2019. Is there any questions on the financial statement for the month of August?
It's not really a question pertaining to this, but I'm just wondering if we could see what our facilities, the last 2 or 3 years over those summer months. Sometimes I look at this and I don't know if that's up or down, or if we
okay.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm just curious about facilities and funding, et cetera.
Okay. On the revenue side of things?
Yeah.
Okay, the fees, I see. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Have you seen an increase in participation in usage?
I believe so.
Last
numbers I looked at.
Particularly in attendance, so that will we can put that back on the fee side of things and the revenue side of things. So yeah, take a look at that. Any other comments or questions? If not, the financial statement for the month of August entered into the record. Next up is a presentation of vouchers. Entertain a motion to bring it to the floor for discussion and questions.
So moved.
Second.
Any questions on vouchers for the month of August?
Yeah, I'm just curious about bulb recycling. It's not a lot of money, but bulb recycling?
Oh, that's the old light bulbs. They'll recycle out some of the old.
The LEDs?
I think it's more of a fluorescent.
The fluorescent?
Yeah. We're kind of moving towards switching everything to LED.
Uh-huh.
But I think as they kind of switch out the old walls.
I was curious what that specifically was about. Did you look into the grant programs and things to switch out to LEDs?
A few years ago, we looked at a couple of things, but I don't think we had kind of the volume or size to qualify. There was a couple of things out there where we looked at a few options for light bulbs and that, but I want to say from that number, we maybe didn't have the amount of
there's a lot. I know that there's a lot of programs out there, especially for not-for-profits or government agencies that they'll help with the cost. I know there's somewhere along that line. I'm sure that everybody's making a little bit of money on that, which is fine. Things don't work unless there's something like that involved. So I just wanted to make sure that we've taken advantage of those opportunities if they're out there for us.
Yeah, we usually try to look at, I know we looked at all the sight lighting, parking lots at one point to see if we switched LEDs, over and that's where we found the return was like 20 to 30 years. So we've been doing it as we do new parks or if we're doing renovations, we'll look at them, but yeah, a lot of times just the cost of changing all the fixtures, updating the lights.
It's expensive, there's no question, you know. We have 60 buildings, so believe me, right?
No, we always try to look at things like from a sustainability standpoint, what we can do to kind of, you know, long-term maintenance costs and that, if there's things we can look to change.
Did you look that up for the snowplows?
Yeah, so that was...
I'm sure you had to, but...
Yeah, no, that was two snowplows, so those are, I want to say they were DeBoss. Basically, we get the plows that are like 8 foot, but they extend out to 10 foot, so... Yeah, they're not.
They got the hydraulic extension.
Yeah, so that was.
We got a bunch of those too.
Yeah. I mean, this stuff is just, you know, for the cost of items, but they're kind of necessary for doing business.
So when you do that, I mean, there's the Boss, there's the Western, there's you know, there's the Myers. Do you go to the different ones, or do you just go to the one that you consider to be?
I think we typically use the Boss.
Yeah, we've tried a number of different plows over the years, and the ones that seem to be holding up the best for us here in Snow Country are the Boss, and so we get cost comparisons on the Boss plow. So,
okay.
If there's something better than that, we would welcome a recommendation, but the guys seem to be happiest with the Bosses.
No, we use both Boss and Western. Myers goes a little. Myers is a Ohio company.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure. So, do you store those inside?
Yeah, we actually we keep them all in garages in the winter.
Good.
So,
well, during the summer months.
I mean, during the summer. Yeah.
Okay. Because the sun is murder on the hydraulics.
I just had a question for you. So you gave us this addendum, you added the Verizon wireless.
I took it off the vehicle.
Oh, okay, because I'm like, I see it up top of there, but I see it down below as well. Okay, so it was just double. Okay.
Right, it's just moving it from one head into another.
Gotcha. Well, it wouldn't be a purchase, it would be a donation.
That's correct, yeah. Yes. Yes. Sorry about that.
Did you ask them why they wanted to give it? They just don't need it and they wanted the tax deduction, or?
He didn't specifically imply that, but it had been in the family for a long time, but the gentleman and his wife lived in Tiffin.
Oh, so this is like their only piece of property they have in this area?
Yeah, they don't live in this area.
Oh, okay.
They don't live in this area, but if you look at his report, it's like all swamp.
Yeah.
So it's not really sellable.
No.
I'm sure by any means it would be.
It's landlocked, and I did drive over there to take a look at where it's at in relationship to the private road that the Peterson family owns, and it's back probably 200 yards on the property.
If they stop paying the taxes, the state will foreclose and become property stable. And then, you know, go with subjective.
So the gentleman did request that we reflect a vote in the board meeting minutes, so he knows what to tell his family, so. Entertain a motion to bring it to the table.
I put a motion to deny.
Or reject.
Reject the donation.
And I think rejection based upon the fact that, you know, the report shows that it's really not a high quality for the park.